Okay, welcome back. So this is the tibia and fibula, now the bones of the lower leg. Now we're not gonna really talk into great detail about the foot yet, that comes after, and we've already talked about the femur. Let me pull the camera out so we get a little bit deeper in through here. So you can see all my stuff on my table. Nod to the Dutch troop waffles. Love those, I got a little can here. So the tibia and the fibula are our leg bones of the lower leg, or bones of the lower leg, with including the patella, of course. Now, there's some features you want to know. There's something I want to show you. I've done this video before. Those of you that have seen it, once this video is out for a long time with my students, this won't be as big a deal. But this fibula was jammed into the tibia too close in, and I should have realized that when I made the first video. It needs more space. So over time, these pins and these screws have brought this in, and it needs to be further out just for our purposes. So I'm going to put a little bit of gum eraser here to give that a little space like it should have. And the reason why, we have muscles that fit into this area of the tibia fibula, starting up here at the tibia, also in the fibula, run all the way down. That's very important. So if this bone is too close, then that won't look right. So let's make sure we understand that. So that's on me for the last lecture. So this is a redo, actually. All right, so now after we've made amends to that, let's identify the bones here, and then let's start to analyze and then obviously draw them. So we have the tibia bone and the fibula bone. Couple things to think about here. The tibia is a very much kind of a triangular prism-like bone, and it is less tubular than you think. It's much more kind of square, even though it's certainly rounded, it's blockier. And it's kind of triangular prism-like. That's something to understand, okay? Grooved in through here. It's also curved more in through here. If I show you this way, we can start to see this little curve in through here. Okay, coming around. It has these great heads on the back, and the head is generally larger on the medial side in the back than it is in the lateral side, because the fibula will attach to the back lateral. We can see here it's kind of in the back, and it's also on the side, so it's the back, kind of the back side, if you will. But it certainly is lateral, and it is pulled back as well. Now, some features to be aware of: the tibia, the top here, is a little flatter, even though it's irregular, but it's flatter. It's called the plateau. All right, now as it comes down the shaft a little bit, this is going to show up quite well on the model. This is the triangular tubercle area, and notice how this really starts to square out. This is kind of it really is a triangled area in through here. We'll see it on the model often, quite often. The patella will float, it's sheathed in ligament and then tendon, and it will float as the action of the leg moves back and forth. It will not move, the patella will not move, but the knee will move, the femur will move, the tibia and fibula will move as well. Now, this kneeling point area is triangular. It has two little bulbed areas for ligament here, attaching all the way over, and tendon coming from all the quads over to the kneeling point, or this bony protrusion. See how it also protrudes out further. You can feel the grooves in through here of the tibia. So we have this greater head, right? But then we have a very narrowing very quickly. You also notice that this starts to curve in through here. Then it really curves this way. The whole leg movement is still taking on this slight angle that the femur has downward. Okay, this is the natural appropriate feeling on the model, on the skeleton, of not straight, but slightly off-centered and moving downward towards the malleolus, or the lateral part of the ankle. More things to know about the tibia, very important things. The central spine of the tibia, can you see how raised that is up and over. This is what we call in terminology, just simple terminology, the shin bone. So if the shin bone gets hit, you've gotten hits often, right? You play football, or you play cricket or field hockey, or you play American football, or you play American baseball, basketball, or you're just riding a bicycle somewhere, maybe in Amsterdam, right? And you hit something, or someone hits you, whatever it is, right? You know that this hurts. And the reason why is this raised S-curve spine, can you feel that S-curve, is protruding here across, and it's like a border. Think of it as the Great Wall of China, okay? All the muscles are on the lateral side, or on the fibula side. The fibialis longus, the fibialis brevis, the extensor digitorum longus, and the tibialis anterior, as well as the hallucis and the brevis of the extensor too as well. So there's a lot to know here. I'm gonna simplify some of that for you because you don't need to know everything right now. On this side, it's barren. It's like a desert. So the medial side is like a desert. This hurts. This is the ouchy side, the side that is not going to feel good when it's hit. What you have here is just inner fossa material that connects these bones. They're like ligaments. It's a little material inside the gap. You can feel the gap right in, so you can see the gap now properly in through here. This is interosseous material. On this side, it's sheathed. It's got material. It's got interosseous and kind of fascia. But back behind it is where the gastrocnemius and the soleus muscle attach and then run down to the Achilles heel on the back of this calcaneus bone here. This is more of the foot bone. The calcaneus, the talus, the tarsals, the metatarsals, and then the phalanges coming on down the foot. We'll get into the foot at a later date. Okay, so we have that beautiful arch spine. This gives the whole rhythm of the leg a curvature. You can't draw the leg. Matter of fact, there's no bone that's straight at all. So you can't give the leg a straight look. It's got to be curved a little bit, okay? Now, let's go over to the fibula. The fibula sits underneath the lateral condyle to a degree of the tibia, right? Let me get in the camera. That would help, wouldn't it? So there's the fibula. Okay, tibia, fibula, and it has these grooved tubercled areas for many different attachments. The biceps femoris comes through here. The longus comes on top of here. So it's a pretty active muscle in through this particular area. It's got interosseous fossa in between the tibia and the fibula. So muscles fit in this groove. This whole area slides back, as does the area to the medial side slides back. So it's very much like an apex to a prism or a triangular kind of bone. Now the fibula is a little bit, again on the lateral side, a little bit shorter. However, this is what's important to know now down below to the ankle, or the malleosis area. We have the medial malleolus in through here, and we have the lateral malleolus in through here. What do you notice about them? You notice that they're at an angle. So to remember that, because I used to get this wrong when I was a student a long time ago, drawing figures out of my head, that the medial malleolus is always higher than the lateral, meaning that there's on a diagonal. So we're high on the inside, we're low on the outside, or you can remember it this way, low lateralis, high medialis, L for low lateralis, and then I'll tell you that's your high here. So there's a diagonal to that. There's also a diagonal, if you think about the condyles now, of the tibia and fibula, here and here, they're the same action diagonally here, right? You see that, and you also see it now down through here. The calf and gastrocnemius will be just the opposite. So you have this beautiful movement of here and here, and the opposite movement of the calf. This will be always giving you rhythm. Artists take advantage of that rhythm all the time. Here to here and over and you get that beautiful kind of gradual stepping diagonals of the rhythm of the leg and through there, okay? Now, as we go back here, so this is the malleolus, the ankle, through here, you can see how it shaves over. This joint here is a hinge joint, okay? So we can see where the foot is giving extension and flexing direction in through here, so we can see that hinge. These bones, the tibia and the fibulus, grab over, let me get the camera, they grab over nicely like this and come over the foot or the talus bone in through here, the tarsal area, and grab pretty nicely. So they're like this wonderful kind of clamped, hinged joint area, okay? Going to the back, this area, it's curved and it's hollowed underneath some. So if I can put this bone straight on the table, we can get still underneath. Now, I'm taking into consideration that the ankle is not touching too. So we still get, look at all that space. So it's still pretty curved. It's like the femur, right? Up in through here. So there's a nice curvature through there. There's a curved area through here and shaved back. And then this gets curved, you can see in the back, and that's where the gastrocnemius and the soleus will attach back here, and that gives you that full view of the back of the calf in through this area, okay? All right, so I think we're ready to start drawing a little bit and taking a look deeper at what is going on and what we can do with this particular bone. So as we start, I think I'll throw a ruler down here. I'm gonna pull in now a little bit. Don't get as much clutter. There we go. I'm gonna throw a couple of straight lines here just because I can. Now, because I wanna show you that we keep this on a curve a little bit, okay? That's gonna be important, and then show you that these straight lines, these bones will not be straight. That's gonna be important as well. So I've got that, I'll put the ruler back over off camera and we'll start to draw a little bit now. All right, so with our bone, so we're gonna include also the femur bone as well. So I'll keep that handy right in through here. So the first thing that we notice now with the bone, I'm gonna keep the straight line next to it so we don't get too confused by it. We've got, make sure we're on camera here. Yeah, we're on camera. Pull that just a little bit. We've got this beautiful line now, the plateau of the tibia. Okay, so we're gonna feel this. In back, it's gonna be like this. It's gonna be a little heavier. Back in through here, okay? So we've got this coming around and down. And I'm also gonna draw it as if we can see back here a little bit. What we also notice about the bone forming through here, it starts to narrow a little bit as we come forward, arches and rounds. So it narrows a little bit. So watch this. So I'm gonna give a little perspective, more perspective in the background for this. So we can see that this will come around more like this, right? And this will start to feel narrowed even more in the front. So we can start to shave off this a little bit in through here, to create even more kind of a prism-like, not prison, but prisoned, prism-like form even in here in the front. So there's your center. Now, we want to keep off that straight area. So now we can come through. We know that's a little bit of a head in through here. Head in through here as well, okay? Now, the femur will come down, and we've got, remember, we've got those condyles to deal with here. And we've got the femur coming down in through here and over. Then they've got those wonderful knuckles, the knuckles of the femur coming in through. So we get a little back coming down. Make sure we get that. Make sure we get that coming down and in. These will go back. I'll give you that back view in through here and up and down through. So we have that. Then, of course, we have those wonderful, let me just get a different color, those wonderful meniscus pads right in here going on in through here. So the meniscus, It's about to break that pencil meniscus pads in through here, sitting in. We've got articular cartilage coming up right in through here, right? And over, in through here. So all that's working for us to protect the movement and the friction so it doesn't, we just don't, you know, ruin ourselves with pain. So we've got a lot of ways to pad ourselves out through this area. So I'm going to take the patella off and we're going to draw now this bone. So we notice that pretty quickly this bone, the tibia, right, we're going to draw the bone, the leg, as if it's the right leg facing us, okay? We start to feel this movement now. We start to feel this triangulation here of this bone, right, starting to come now this way. So that's important. So we start to feel this area moving forward and it's triangulating out. So we have this kind of top condyle and it really starts to get narrower. Notice how much more narrow it gets, right, as we come on down the shaft. That's important to see. So we're coming on down the shaft and through here and it starts to get narrow and then it starts to turn here and really get narrow. This gets to what we call that kneeling point or that tubercle triangle of the tibialis. Tubercle triangle of the tibialis. Say that a couple of times fast. The tubercle triangle of the tibialis. And we get these little beads in through here, these kneeling points, and they pop out from the lateral side quite well. So we start to see that, okay? So these get shaved down and shaved on in. So don't be shy about that, right? About bringing that on into to play here. There we go. So we'll clean that up a little bit, charcoal. So we have that idea, design-wise. And what happens when the patella floats, these tendons coming from the medialis, the rectus femoris, the vastus intermedius, and the vastus lateralis coming at us, right? Those quads are all coming over and sheathing over that patella. And with that tendon, we have the ligament, patellar ligament. Now it's bone to bone. We have all of them coming on down and going to attach through and sheath over in these areas. Now the knee has a lot more going on than just what we draw, quite frankly. There's quite a bit of, there's an anterior cruciate ligament, posterior. There are other ligaments, tendons. Lots of interosseous fossa that's going on to wrap and sheathe and help this most fragile area. We have a very fragile area because of all the tension, stress, and turning and twisting and opening of this joint. I can attest to the difficulties of this area by being a former athlete and how difficult this area can take stress. It's amazing we don't hurt any more often. All right, so I'm gonna come down now and I'm gonna mark the area. Now it kind of's gonna sit to the side a little bit. There we go. I'm gonna mark this area to get this length a little bit. It's a little bit bigger than, whoops, coming over. Our bone, set up bone. There we go, it's very testy, this bone. Okay, doesn't wanna always cooperate. There we go, I think it's in the ankle area. So we wanna get this curvature off this, right? We want to get this feeling a little bit. We don't want to go too much, but we notice this rhythm of this S-curve, right? So we want to come here, downward, over about, almost about halfway. We notice this S-curve here, coming over, through, and down to the beginning of the lateral malleosus, so malleolus. So again, we're relating to this line, this straight line, we have to be careful. We don't want a straight line. So now we're coming to the malleolus, and it almost lines up really with the outside head of the condyle on the medial side, doesn't it? So we can come back to it here, roughly right in through here. Now as we come down, we notice that the spine starts to give way. So the spine gives way and straightens out a little bit, but it keeps on going to the lateral malleolus. You know, I'll mispronounce that a bunch of times today. I already have a couple of times. Here we go. This becomes that strong head of that spine, that S-curve, right in through here. So everything after that shaves down this way, right? Shaves down that way. It's like a prism. So the whole bone, in essence, is like this here, okay? With the shaving down here, shaving down there, meaning that it's moving in that direction downward, okay? So we have the malleolus through here. Now we want to get the other side, hit the tubercled side of it through here, okay? It gets narrower through here. This wants to come over, barrel over, and then get pretty shaved back. So it's relatively straight, comes in and over, curves over with it, and there we are to right the malleolus coming downward to the through the medial malleolus in here. And then remember, it grabs. So now it's starting to grab the talus, the calcaneus area of our bone. Kind of squares off through here at an angle, doesn't it? Right in through here and over. Okay, and around, like so. Does it pretty nicely. Okay, coming over, has a little bit of a hood now to it, like that, okay? And then it ends by coming back over, kind of a little nub in through here and back in through. And then we're gonna come in and slink a little bit. Watch this. So this is kind of a hub, a nubbed hub in through here. Straighten out a little bit, come on up. And it's gonna get really close to that spine, right in through there, up, 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 and then start to break and get wider as we come up the shaft now of the tibia and through there. Okay, there's a lot going on in the knee area that we can start to really understand how fragile but how complex all of it is. So we have a nice, I think we have a nice look now to our bones. So I'm going to start to kind of shade this down and give you that feeling of that spine coming through here, of what's happening. This really goes, again, goes back. You really want to feel that coming back. And the reason why is, later on, that the calf here and the gastrocnemius, now we're going to have an aspect that, since we have, we're low on the lateral side, so the design is here, that means that the aspect of the calf in the gastrocnemius will look something like, if we'll just put a little bit of that muscle out and through here, they'll head here on down and come on up and over. The medialis, or the medial head of the gastrocnemius, is longer and larger than, at least it's longer than the lateral head. So it will come up and feel something like that coming on down. That's important to see and note too as well. Now, the fibula. Let's demonstrate that a little bit on the front aspect of it. So we know that it's lower here, right? So, and it's sitting back behind a little bit further. We can see it back here, how much more behind it is on the lateral aspect than it is in the front. And so in order to get that, of course, we have a nice gap in between too, where there, again, the interosseous material is laying in for us to connect these two areas together like ligaments, okay? Ligament-like. This would come down and keep that pretty light. So we're gonna sit back here a little bit. It's lower than, sitting nestled in this aspect, nestled to it, connected by ligaments. It has a head and little tubercled areas where we get attachments to the biceps femoris, as well as the longus area, probably not quite as high, of the fibialis muscle. Now, we take into aspect that it's curved a little bit, but we want to keep that back, the gap in between, so we'll get this aspect like this, coming down, and then we're going to connect down through and slightly behind the medial aspect the lateral aspect of the tibia, through here slightly behind and through here, then around and over. We've got to go lower now, okay, for that bone to come through the head of it. It's going to be lower in through here. It's kind of like a ball or a disc in through here and over. Okay, just a blunt shape, and everyone's a little bit different. You can keep it generalized, which we do here for simplicity's sake. And then coming on up and over, you're noticing now a twist right in through here of that bone about a third of the way up, down, right through here. So this twists over a little bit. It does the same kind of curvature, then comes back out a little bit here and straightens out. And then we come on down to the ending point here. So there's a little curvature that goes through here as well. It's pretty powerful little area going on through the fibula. So again, I mentioned that they're connected by interosseous material in between here. That won't show up in our muscle anatomy. That won't show up, but they are connected. You'll want to know that. So we can feel this pocket in this divot here coming over. This kind of material, this a real strong ridge over in through here. So we can kind of shade that a little bit. Meniscus, bursa sacs in this area. That'll give us this kind of look too as well. That's going to help too. So I'll put maybe a little shading in through here. So we've got this beautiful calf muscle. Everybody loves the beautiful gastrocnemius and soleus area. And again, that aspect of it is a downward diagonal trend now, okay? And so as we come down and through, this will come all the way down and attach back behind down to the calcaneus bone, down and through roughly in through that area. And so the reason why I'm just kind of feeling this just a little bit is to show you how much the bone and the calf do not align. The bone comes through, the calf's a little more angled in that area as well. Now, we have the spine here, okay? And so it'd be good to articulate that where I can shade it down below or at a different angle here. We can see that let you see that come through a little bit. So it really is a high ridge here. High ridging here, high ridging here, okay? High ridge here, and it shaves down and back. This would pull around, like so, and around like that. We see that aspect now coming back, and so we can see this pull back this way as well. Very important to get that feeling of that aspect of that spine. And then we can take a little bit of our eraser here, and I'll take out a little bit of that spine in through here. And we'll come back and put a little bit of lights in there, like so. So we can see that emerge a little bit better. So this would head out. If you get that S curve about halfway down in through and then on back and on over. And we start to see that really begin to emerge. Points here as well, in terms of our bony protrusions on that kneeling point, right in through those areas. So we get a nice curvature through all that good stuff in through here. Then of course the leg bone, it comes down and grabs on that calcaneus, and then we'll leave it kind of a relaxed sort of skeletal position like that. It would come down and then we get this coming out here. And we'll talk about all the muscles and tendons that attach there, and then all this wants to just fall out the area here, and then downward, and then bulge out, and this will come down a little bit. And that's all we'll fuss with for now as we look at the tibia and fibula now in a lateral aspect now to the side aspect. Let's take a look at that as well. So we have our straight line now, okay, set up. We had a nice curve to it, so that kept us in a good position to keep that curve. So the lateral aspect, now we want to keep our curve. Like I was saying, I had to cut back a little bit to sharpen my pencils. Came back and then freshened up this drawing on this side a little bit, added a little light, cleared it out a little bit, keep my dry diagrams as clean as we can. So the lateral aspect, we know that this whole system is curved. Take a look at that curvature in through here. So we don't want to draw it again straight. We want to have a curvature to that aspect. That's important to see. So as we come through now, we'll bring over some guidelines to keep our structure the same length. How about that? So we'll come over here. I'll just bring that over a little bit to help me through. We're showing a little bit of this top, even though we might not see it like that. We have a little bit of this, a little bit of that. Down below here, the malleolus, the medial and lateral malleolus, just to help us through a little bit to bring that over. That'll be nice. So we're coming through now with this drawing, and we want to say, all right, so this area is pretty bulky in theory, pretty blocky, but it's got a bulkier lateral head to it on the side of it. On the back side, there's an angle to it, and I'll show you that when we draw the back. It's more bulky on the medial, so don't worry about it. It's relatively important, but it, you know, you, as long as you think of this as a simple kind of a blocky cone, you're going to be pretty much always all right. So let's start out. What we see here, like so, is this bulkiness now in the back area, like through. We come over a little bit, and we see this come on down and then get triangular, right, pretty quick. So we come on down, right, we see that, and we get these kneeling points, because this is all coming in, right? This is all getting shaved in, coming on down. Then we see those kneeling points here, or those tubercles here, and then also here. There's side now, kind of side B. So we get this aspect of this, bulge, and then bulge as we come on down. So we get that moving little beads in through here. So this comes around and over, we get this shaved area in, right? And then this all starts to move back in perspective like this, or give us a little bit of a divot or a pocket in there. And we come down and we get this big bulkier head in through here. Then right under here, again, that's where our fibula is going to start attaching to, and you can see where it's got these tubercled grooves in through here where we're going to attach that biceps femoris. Now I'm going to give you a little top view of that in through here, so this would widen out here and curve now, so where this all aspect is curved a little bit, and so we get a little this little triangular tubular prism-like quality to it in through there. Okay, so we have that. Now we'll come down, I'll just draw the tibia first. So we have this curve to it coming on down, so we're curving like this. This aspect curves down a little bit. It's not straight. We know this is straight here, curving on down. And we get back here to the malleolus in through here, coming on down a little, curving through the malleolus, right in through here into the medial side of central side of it, through here. And then we'll come back, the kneeling point, look how much that wants to come in now and get thinner. And now we're on relatively that spine here of the tibia right in through here, that strong spinal area that we get to. So we poke out further, right? We see that, and then we see that curve want to come gently back on in. Gets a little thinner now as we get to the inner part of the malleolus and into the top edge ridge of this ankle, which this is now the bulbed area of that area right in through here, okay? So we don't see that medial malleolus underneath making that kind of arched curvature. So this now gets all shaved in. So we're here on this side, all of this now comes back, right? Gets shaved down. This is the top head of the spine. We won't see the central part of that white part of the spine that I showed you over here, okay? What we're gonna see is this shaved aspect. So all of this very gently gets shaved down. You can go back this way. Now I can change it and go back this way if I want. Either way, it's fine. Depends on your perspective. Keep it like that. Then down here it gets more tubercle about the lower third area. It starts to get more tubular, and then it gets into this bulbous area in through there. So we start to get that, right? And then we get this rounding out down in through underneath here a little bit. Now, let's take on the fibula, okay? The patella would be up in through here a little bit. Get this a little straighter. Patella, roughly right in through here, floating and sitting through here, wider at the top. We get a little side view in through here, and that ligament and tendon area are all gonna come down and catch on to that tubercled area, right in through here, and out and over, and catch on to these two areas and connect very strongly to that area. I'll leave off the femur for this one. Now the fibula, okay, notice that it overlaps now the space in between. So I can see on the space I've got between for the interosseous material coming through. It gets wider at the top a little bit narrower at the bottom, depending on the skeletal aspect. I've seen some where they're wider, I can push it out a little bit further and let that come through. But they do overlap, okay? So we have that back head now of the fibula coming through. It also has a little bit of a curve, as you notice. So we're all in this wonderful kind of curved area. So we get a front view of that. Okay, so this curves in, it's gonna overlap. So it sits laterally, and that's why it's overlapping a little bit. See how it fits underneath this groove here? It fits really nicely underneath the tibial groove in the back. So here, it kind of just takes on the same line. I'm gonna bring it in a little bit further. It kind of takes on the same line as the tibula, and on down, okay, in through here. Now we're gonna go lower, right, with the lateral malleolus in through here. So it comes down lower then, heads up, it's got a head to it, okay, right in through here. It's got that head in through here and up in through, so we get more of that curve down in through. Show it like a little shadow there too as well. Put a line there and then more of a shadow line to show you that difference. In through here, around, tubed off, and then more shaved down, and then could be up too as well. A bit more dynamic in through there. So that's grooved in through, grooved in through that area. So now, let's go back and find the fibula line in through here. All the action of the muscles are gonna be sitting in this groove. The longus, the brevis, the extensor digitorum longus, the tibialis anterior. Remember, they're all gonna be on the lateral side of the border of the spine, right in through here. So that spine, I'm gonna put S for spine, is important. It's also a border, so you have to remember that. Everything on this side will be muscle. So this will be greatly, this area will have a lot of bulk to it as well. We also want to show now in this particular view the calcaneus bone, because it's important as it sits here. The talus is in through here, okay, the tarsals, this area, but then this calcaneus bone coming down and underneath here gives you this kind of shape here, right in through here and over. Make sure We're still in the camera barely. Let me push up just a little bit. Yeah, I think we've got it shaved over. This is important. You're going to find this in a moment, especially when we get into muscles and over. Okay. You know, I'll just leave it. Now at that, this area is where we're going to attach the soleus and the gastrocnemius, and this becomes your Achilles. So let's look at that shape a little bit of what's going on. I'm not going to talk about more than just its shape coming down and through, but you'll see the heads of them together. I'm just going to draw the outline. And they bulge in here a little bit, okay, like so. Coming down, you've seen that shape quite a bit in here, and then you'll see them start to detach here and then come all the way down to that long tendon in through here and give us that Achilles, right? And attaching all the way and sheeting over here. This Achilles all the way up and through. Okay, we get the gastrocnemius and this over it mostly, and then a little bit of the soleus coming through to give it more bulk in this area, and that's how that will look with that direction. So all the action of the muscles of the tibia and fibula are on the lateral side of the form, much more so. Kneeling point in through here, in through there as well. So that's important to see that aspect as we move along now. Okay, so we have that. Coming down, if we will, through here. All right. So now let's move on to a back aspect or posterior aspect. We clean this up a little bit. I guess I will say this, actually, in the front, one more thing I could show you is the tibialis anterior muscle will give, this is not the full story over here, it will give this feeling, because you're thinking, something's not right. You're right. This muscle here will attach up, the tibialis anterior up and through here, and bulk out a little bit with the extensor and give us, remember that diagonal look we wanted, right? It will give us a little bit of this muscle to come through like so. Remember that when you draw? So this is straighter, this aspect is straight for just a little bit after the bone, and then we get a little bit of that bulking ridge, right? And then we go back in and through, and that disappears, so we get a little bit of this together. That will help too in your understanding. All right, let's get one more back view, and I think we've got what we needed. We can go into more living diagrams after our muscles. So now you can see the gap returning into the tibia and the fibula with this aspect. Okay. Let's see if I can get this set through here, get it all together. There we go. Stay. All right. So we've got that there now. You'll have to hold on to it as I draw, perhaps. All right. So coming over here, let's bring over our guidelines to help us out here and here and down below. The malleolus areas are just for a little help, and through here, calcaneus, just to give an example there. And so let's start into what we notice here as we start to draw. We hit this plateau here, so we're plateaued here, okay? And we see that now on the medial side, this plateau does this backside and through here. So we see this coming over. And if there's this angle that happens, so the medial head in the very back is bulkier. That happens to play off the bulkiness now of the fibula, because it's shaved off. So the bone shaved off of the tibia and back, so the fibula can really be put back there. So we're going to undercut this. Remember, in the back, so the front's a little bit more narrower. It's something like this, more triangular. Again, that prism-like quality to the area. And so then we get we get a little bit more specific. We get this little hubbing in through here, and we get that in through there. And then we want to start coming down. Now we come down and we feel this stalked like curve. Okay, we really dig in through here, right? So you can see this turnover and turnover in through there. This minus the fibula does the same thing. It comes in and curves in. It's making a lot of exception for that fibula to fit in, okay? So now we get, since we're on now the medial side, we're gonna get a little bit more curvature here. It's not straight. Here's our straight line to make sure. And then we're divin' in. So this area through here is at the lowest point of the trough, if you will, meaning that it's all turning in and back, and then this comes up and out a little bit. This comes up and out a little bit through here. So it's difficult to show. So it can gets a little narrower, and then it starts to come up again, get wider and through here. And now we're getting now over to the medial malleolus, which lines up decently with the outside medial condyle, coming down now over, right? And we start to see it kind of like a wheel hub underneath here. So that's going to start attaching, go lower like this. And through, and this is where that gets nice and shaved downward back in, right? And so that comes on in to, or downward a little bit, and grabs onto that calcaneus bone. Now this comes over, squares off a little bit, and it ends, remember, with that hub right in through here. So this hub is here, this little kind of old area, and over, right? So we have that, and we'll come back up. This gets a little shaved in through here, okay? And we groove through there, and we're doing pretty good. Remember, this is the lowest point, right up in this area is the lowest point of the tibial-fibial area. So it's, again, it's curved. So we're right in through here, and as we're trying to show that curve comes back up and gets a little bit thicker too. Now we want to put on the fibula. So the fibula sits nestled in the back, doesn't it? You can see where, how far back it is. It's angled here, right, as it sits through right in this area, okay, and then down. And it's kind of like a light bulb head in through, like a flower bulb, maybe a tulip that hasn't quite bloomed through there, okay. And then there's that separation. Then we have that stalk coming down of the bone. Now we're going to wind up here, so you can kind of draw the heads down. And they're attached by the ligaments. Okay, this kind of gets shaved. So now the aspect of this is pretty interesting. So we have to be, you know, mindful of what's higher and what's lower. In the back, it's a little different looking than the front, isn't it? Because we know that the medial is higher, the lateral, right, is lower. So the lateral is lower and the medial is higher. Here they look more of the same in through here. So a little bit less of that to go. So in reality, if we look right through here, they really are lined up about the same. So it gets changed off in the back a little bit. So about the same coming down through the fibula. This gets shaved over, turned in a little bit like so, kind of heads out and then up, it's connected. And we get a little bit of this curvature. It's almost straight. A little bit of curvature in and then back over to its the shaft. This gets a little side view in through here. Coming back over, we want to keep a little bit of that gap going through here. So here's where our gap is. Okay, like so. And a little thinner coming down. Okay, coming down through and over, and it's going to attach right in through there. In the aspect now of the fibula is also turned, remember, it's shaved over, so about right halfway-ish over this gets turned in, so all this gets shaved back this way. I'll show you, it's grooved. You want to pick up these bones at some point when you can after a lecture and just start looking and learning right in through here. Okay. Shave back in that direction. All right, so we have, let's clean this up a little bit, so get our separation working for us. Coming down here. And over, and they groove together, and they'll overlap a little bit, about right in through here. That's what I see on mine, maybe a little bit lower. Right in through, there we go. Make a little dark for that to show through. Okay, and all this area now is lower. It's curved, so I'll darken this area in further. That gets curved. That's important to see. Curved it up. This comes out in arches because it's higher in our perspective. Now we get our calcaneus bone down here. So we're way down here in the camera. It's a little off center. Okay, so we have this kind of hubbed head. Talus in through, we have this hubbed head. That's lower. Okay, kind of triangular in aspect here and downward. Comes down, hubs over like this. There we go. Each one is a little different, but it's the same overall basic structure. And through here, more bone in through here. And right along this entire area is where the Achilles tendon, or the Achilles heel, right, will be the tendon of the gastrocnemius and the soleus areas. Connected together will make that Achilles heel area. All right, so there we go, the tibia now and the fibula. Very strong bones connected together. They're always together. They're like Romeo and Juliet. They're lovers. They always want to be connected by interosseous material and fiber, and by the front muscles, the extensors in the back, the flexors, to give us a strong, torqued, balanced muscle in the back. This could be a little bit bigger in the back of our leg to help us balance and be able to walk together. You take this Achilles heel out and it's going to be tough to walk. Let's get the look of the calf, since we've done them on all these. The soleus will attach here. The gastrocnemius will attach up here. Their whole aspect, remember, lower on the medial side, so it will feel like this. Okay, our calf here, it will feel like this. Okay, and then we will come up and be higher now on the lateral side. So lower on the medial, okay, and higher, more angled this way on the lateral side of things. So that's what our calf muscle will look like, and then we'll come down and everything starts to get tubed and cone-like and head on down to Achilles heel land. Right on down and through. That's important to see. I don't want to make too much of an issue out of it, but we start to see that coming on through, coming on down the pipe. Pretty fun and interesting stuff to work with. So that's really next. The next lecture is to get those muscles under your belt, so to speak. Your names are a little bit harder to work with. But there you go, that's the tibia now and the fibula. Good stuff. And you want to commit that to memory by drawing your diagrams often, and then put your diagrams to living diagrams, meaning that are dynamic diagrams, active, meaning put them in different positions, and then you can commit, once you commit those to memory, you know, and it's constantly look at the model and draw from the model to help your diagrams as well. But you want to be able to draw these diagrams in your front, back, in the side aspect, and then later on you can work, once you get those, you can work with foreshortening too as well after that. Okay, all right. Okay, so I will see you ladies and gentlemen very soon with our next lectures. You guys take care out there. Bye-bye.